So today we'll be seeing what is accommodation reflex and also the pathways involved in it. So what is accommodation? The ability of eye to adjust its focal length when it moves the vision from distant object to near object is called accommodation. So what are all the three main features of accommodation? So first is pupillary constriction. Second, convergence of eyeballs. And third, increase in the curvature of lens. So when the pupil constricts, it will prevent the divergence of light rays and concentrates the light rays on the nearby objects. The convergence of eyeballs and increase in the lens curvature helps to focus the nearby objects and increases the depth of focus. So how is all these three things achieved in accommodation? So when the light is shown on the eye, the impulses is carried via the ganglionic cell layer of the retina. From here, the axons of this cell layers pass through the optic nerve. From the optic nerve, it goes to the optic chiasma, where the nasal fibers from each hemiretina decussate. From the optic chiasma, it goes to the optic tract. From the optic tract to the lateral geniculate body or geniculate nucleus of the thalamus. From the lateral geniculate nucleus, via the optic radiation, it relays in the primary visual cortex of the occipital lobe. The information from the primary visual cortex is then relayed also to the visual association cortex. From the visual association cortex, which is also present near the primary visual cortex and the occipital lobe, the information is transferred to the Edinger-Westphal nucleus. The Edinger-Westphal nucleus is present in the midbrain and it is a parasympathetic ganglion. From this Edinger-Westphal nucleus, preganglionic fibers pass through the oculomotor nerve to the ciliary ganglion. The ciliary ganglion is also a parasympathetic ganglion, but it is present at the periphery, that is in the apex of the orbit. After relaying in the ciliary ganglion, the postganglionic fibers pass via the short ciliary nerve to the ciliaris muscle and sphincter pupillae. The sphincter pupillae is also called as constrictor pupillae. This is the muscle in the iris, which when stimulated causes pupillary constriction and reduces the size of pupil. The ciliaris muscle helps in making the lens more spherical. Apart from these two, the oculomotor nerve that arises from the oculomotor nucleus, which is also present in the midbrain near to the Edinger-Westphal nucleus. It is ventral to the Edinger-Westphal nucleus. The information from the oculomotor nucleus is passed via the oculomotor nerve to the medial rectus muscle and causes adduction of eyeballs. So adduction of eyeballs results in convergence of eyeballs. So this is how all the three features of accommodation, such as the pupillary constriction, convergence of eyeballs, and increase in the curvature of the lens, is being brought about. So we can just have a quick schematic representation of the nuclei in the midbrain. So this is the transverse section of midbrain at the level of superior colliculus. So this is the cerebral aqueduct, and surrounding this is a group of neurons which is also called as periaqueductal gray. So the nucleus here is the Edinger-Westphal nucleus, which is a parasympathetic nucleus, and this nucleus is the oculomotor nucleus. So the signals from Edinger-Westphal nucleus and the signals from oculomotor nucleus pass via the oculomotor nerve. So you can see the oculomotor nerve traverses the red nucleus, and it comes out as oculomotor nerve, and it supplies the extraocular muscles of the eyeball.